Well, hello, my beautiful people. Welcome back to my channel if you're returning, and if you are new, welcome to you as well. This is Christine, your DIY craftaholic.
So this is our Easter spring look off the hook challenge. I'll talk a little bit more about that in the video. So let's get crafting. So for our first DIY, I'll be using this pizza board that I got from Woodpecker's Craft and this napkin that I got from May, my friend. So I painted the board with my Waverly plaster, both sides. And now I'm using a paintbrush with a little water on the tip of it just to remove the center of the napkin. And I'm only going to be using that one panel. So I remove that. And here it is. I'll put that in the middle. Remove the back ply from it. And now I'm adding the napkin using a little Mod Podge. And this is the napkin decoupage technique. I love decoupaging. You probably realize how much I love decoupage by now. It's just easy. It doesn't take a lot. And if you don't have a Cricut or anything to make your graphics, using a napkin is great. I'm doing it in sections. So once I put the top down, I use the heat gun and just dry that. And I'll link a video at the top so you can see how I do napkin decoupage if this is your first time seeing this technique. So after I put that on, I use a piece of parchment paper and my little heat press. And what this does is reactivate the Mod Podge to help to seal the napkin down. Now I decided to use the border of the napkin to go around the border of the board, because I just love the pattern on here. So that's what I'm doing. I'm just cutting it off in sections. Because the board is round and the napkin is square, I had to do it in sections. And I'll do the same technique where I use the Mod Podge, spread it thin, remove the back ply, and then place the napkin on top of that. And then just use the heat to reactivate and dry. And I went all the way around, just cutting and pasting down, and you'll see at the end.
About Easter so early in the year. Well, Easter falls very early this year, and since I'm starting my Easter videos or Easter DIYs, I'd like to share a scripture with you. Matthew 28:5-6 says, "But the angel said to the woman, 'Do not be afraid, for I know that you seek Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has risen, as he said. Come see the place where he lay.'" Now this is so fitting for this napkin.
And here I am, almost done.
I left this part in here so you can see how I am using the square napkin to go around this round board. I'm just slitting different parts of the napkin because I didn't want to cut all of the pieces off separately. So as I go around with the long piece, I slit little places where the curves are and then just glue them on off each other.
Now that is all done, I place the parchment paper over everything and use a heat press and just seal that. And now we are ready to move on to the next step. So I took the little emery board and just file off the excess in a downward motion, and I'm already loving how this is turning out. Now you can go all the way up to the top if you like. I chose to stop at the neck of the board, and then in my mind I thought it needed a little bit more
pizzazz.
So I took the gold pen or the gold marker and I thought I would just highlight the word or some parts of the word with the pen. At first it felt like a grand idea and that would have made it look so beautiful, but when I was doing it I didn't like it, but I was already committed, so I had to continue. Next, I took a piece of my ribbon. This ribbon, burlap ribbon, is from the Dollar Tree, and I'm making a bow. So I just cut off a piece, glued down the end, one piece on top of the other, and then I took another piece, gathered that up in the middle, tied along with the bow with a piece of jute cord, and then dovetail the ends, and you have a bow. And then I took the lighter and I just singed the end of the ribbon and then just glued it on at the top. You can also leave a little extra jute cord at the back and just tie it around. I didn't do that because I planned to do something else with the other side, because as you guys know, I love reversibles and there's a lot of real estate at the back of your project. So go ahead and use it. So I decide I'm going to be using that for a future DIY. Next, to bring a little greenery in the mix, I had these two pieces of lamb's ear. I just glued them under the bow. And then I took another little burlap ribbon and glued that in the center of the bow. And to keep the tail of the ribbon from flapping over or hiding the word, I just tacked them down to the side with a little hot glue. And then I took a piece of this ribbon that I got from the Dollar Tree and used that as the hanger. Cut a piece of the ribbon, fed it through the hole, glue down the ends, and then just tack it down with a little hot glue to keep it from swinging around. And this DIY is done. I love it. Love it, love it, love it, love it. Let me know what you think about this, guys, in the comments down below. Now, this is Easter or spring look of the hook challenge. I host this challenge with my friends Jackie from Crafting in Mimi's World and CJ from CJ DIY. And each month or each time we have this challenge, we have a guest host. And this time we have Raisha from Pretty DIYs.
For either Easter or spring or both. So make sure to check out the host channels as well as the guest host channel and the playlist.
I will leave the links to their channels in the description box below. Make sure to check them out when you get done watching my video, of course. Now let's jump into our second DIY. So I'll be using this canvas that I picked up from the Dollar Tree and this heat transfer. I got these in a pack of 16 from Amazon. I will link that in my Amazon storefront. And I'm going to be using my HTV heat press. I've never used it on canvas like this before. I did make some cushions. I also have some that I will show in this video as well.
I used some of the iron-on transfer in the video that I reviewed the HTV heat press. I will link that at the top. You can check that one out.
I also have the cushions linked in my Amazon storefront. Now I'm using some Waverly Antique wax and a little coffee latte from Folk Art.
I apologize for the shaking of the camera.
And I just blended both the antique wax and the paint together, and I'm using a dry chippy brush to just dry brush the canvas. I didn't want it too heavy and I wanted to capture the same color that's on the heat transfer. Now that's done, I took a book because I wanted to have something sturdy where the canvas could rest on while I use it. And here I'm just putting the transfer down, making sure that it's even. And rather than using my heat press, my HTV heat press here, I'm using my mini heat press. And I'm taking my time to make sure that I press that on, that because it's transfer, you want to make sure that all the areas are properly transferred before you start lifting it. So once I did that, I allowed it to cool because you have to let it cool as well. And here I'm just removing the transfer. And look at this, guys, it says faith. We have a wooden cross, some flowers around it, and the word faith in the middle. And I love the colors. Now then, I need something to hang it. So I flipped it over and I'm using a piece of the two-tone jute cord. And I'm just gluing that at the back. I don't want it hanging too high. So I spread it wide and then just tacked it down again to give me a shorter hang. And then I flipped it back over, and now to seal the transfer in, I'm using a little Mod Podge. Now this is optional, you don't have to do this, but I thought that just adding the Mod Podge would give it a finished look and will also help to protect the transfer. And that's it, guys. There is nothing more that I'm going to be doing to this. More in the final reveal. And now we are at DIY number 3. Now, because I did that, I just thought that I would add some spring in here. So there is the heat press to the side. Like I said, that video where I reviewed it will give you a bit more information on how it is used. These cushion covers I also got, and I used them in the review as well, so I won't go into too much detail. So I'm just pressing them out using the heat press, and I'm just going to show you how I transferred on the heat transfer. Now that is done, these are the transfers that I selected. These can be used on t-shirts, but I'm using them for cushion covers. I will only show you one or two. I don't remember if I did two or I did one, but I'll only show you one, and then you'll see the rest in the final reveal. So I placed the Teflon over the transfer, and I heated the press to about 380 degrees, and it's automatically set at 20 seconds. And when the time runs down, you will hear it beep. I know HDV had a sale, like 25% off the heat press up until the 31st. If you check that video that I reviewed it in, a coupon code is in that video. I'll also link it here, so you can see that for easy reference. Now we are past the 31st, so the sale would have ended, but you never know. So you can still check the website to see whether or not it's still going on. Now I allowed them to cool, and this one says grow positive thoughts. And here I peeled off the transfer for that one. Peeling off the transfer for this one, and this says be real, not perfect. And I believe I did 3 of them, if I'm correct, but you'll see them in the final reveal. Now for DIY number 4, this is a piece of scrap wood that I had used in a previous project. I got this from the hardware store, and what I did, I just took the sanding block and sanded it down. The board is already painted, so I just gave it one coat of Waverly plaster. And here I'm going with a piece of this napkin that I got from my friend May. I love the flowers on here, and it matches the theme, the color theme or scheme that I'm going with for this video. So I remove the middle, and this one says he lives. And basically I'm doing the same process like what I did in the first one. So I won't go into too much details about this one. You'll just see what I'm doing. If you are new to my channel or coming over from the playlist, welcome. I'm so happy you joined me today. Here on my channel, I do DIYs on a budget, dupes, look for less, and some occasional Dollar Tree shopping hauls and thrift flips. If you love budget-friendly DIYs like these and you have not yet subscribed, please consider subscribing and be sure to hit that notification bell. Hit it again and select all so YouTube notifies you whenever I upload new videos. So after I mod podged the piece in the middle, the outer pieces, I just cut them down and decoupaged those on the wood to the left and also to the right.
If you're enjoying the video so far, don't forget to hit that like button, share button, comment down below, and also subscribe. And I want to thank you so much for joining me here today. I really do appreciate your support.
And then when I was done with everything, I placed the parchment paper over it and do the heat press method again. I use a sanding block to sand off the excess. So now that is done, I thought that it needed toning down a little bit. So I took some Waverly antique wax and a piece of wet baby wipe, and I'm just distressing the border. Baby wipe wasn't working effectively, so I'm now going in with a sponge dabber, and that gave me better results. So I just tap, wipe, tap, swipe, and I love that. And then now to distress the front of the board, I use a dry chippy brush, the same brush that I used on the canvas. And I'm just removing the excess on a piece of paper towel and just giving light strokes across the surface.
To seal this a little bit more, I took some Mod Podge on the same napkin that I was using with the same chippy brush, and I just went across the surface.
And now as I looked at it, I didn't like how the word was too pale. You could hardly see it. So I just went over it with a black Sharpie. I have these rolls that I made some months ago using a silicone mold that I got from Amazon. I linked that in my Amazon storefront, and I had made them with some clay from Dollar Tree and left them. So these are very, very dry. They are well cured. So I had painted one in red and one in green, and these just work perfectly on here. And the other one I had left that plain.
Just to let you know, guys, that there are changes coming to this channel, so stay tuned. All right, so for our final DIY, we're coming in for a landing, guys. I'm using this cradle painting box from Woodpecker's Craft and some of their mini mushrooms. I'm going to be making a riser. I am so in love with doing risers. I've done quite a few. And then I use some wood glue and hot glue to glue on the mushrooms to the base. Next, I mixed a little Dutch aqua from Folk Art and some plaster chalk paint, and used a sponge dabber and painted the box. I mixed it because I didn't want it too stark. And now that is done, I left the inside on paint because I will be adding contact paper there. And to make this look cohesive, I took some antique wax on a baby wipe and I stained the base as well as the legs. And this is the contact paper. I got this at the 99 cent store. So what I did, I just measure the space that I needed to fit it in, and then cut off that piece, peel it off, pasted it in, and then use the brayer to just smooth it out, and then cut off the excess. And then I took this transfer, rub-on transfer, and I selected We Love Hope, and I just transferred that on. And you want to take your time when you're transferring this on, and then you just remove the top piece, and here it is, guys. Love it. And then just to seal the transfer, I just used some Mod Podge on a small brush and just went over that. And then to distress it a little bit, I'm using the baby wipe with a little antique wax. Dab, 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 and swipe. Dab, 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 and swipe. Just so it doesn't look so stark. I don't have a problem with starkness, but I just wanted to bring in a little bit of the brown that's on the contact paper on the outside. And then after that, I went over it with some Mod Podge. And that is it, guys. And now we're here for the final reveal. Let me know which one of these five projects today was your favorite. I think the ones with the faith and the he lives. Well, let me not just go there. All of them were my favorite. Can I say that? All of them were my favorite. But that is me. I want to know which one was your favorite. Thank you so much for sticking around, guys. Don't forget to check out the host channels, Jackie, CJ, and Raisha, as well as the playlist that is filled with a lot of inspiration for you. And this cushion cover, I had already done this. So I'm just showing you this because I took it off my sofa. And then the others, I'll just show you what they look like. And these are also linked in my Amazon storefront if you're interested in purchasing these. I got them in a set of four. So here is everything. To follow me on social media, you can scan this QR code to my Linktree address, and there you will find all the platforms to reach, or check my description box for more information. So there it is, guys. Don't forget to check out the host channels. And if you have not yet subscribed, please go ahead and do so before you leave. And if you enjoyed this video today and you love to see budget friendly crafts, I suggest this video right here. Or to binge a little bit more, I suggest this playlist. And stay safe, my friends, until my next one. Bye.